Hi guys, continuing our answer writing series for civil services main, today we will discuss the right to constitutional remedies is often described as more fundamental of all fundamental rights. Explain. As you people might be aware that right to constitutional remedies, when Dr. Ambedkar was discussing this particular right under Article 32 of Indian Constitution, he mentioned it is the fundamental of all fundamental rights. That means without this, the constitution is having no meaning. So, describing Article 32, right to constitutional remedy, Ambedkar said it is the most fundamental of all fundamental rights. Then, our constitution is based on the principle of checks and balances. So, our constitution is which the organization shouldn't be. Be more powerful, which will take the power of other, which will lead to citizens at the mercy of a very powerful executive, which might be disregard the lawful rights of its citizens. That is the reason why our founding fathers wanted to clip the wing of a powerful executive through the right to constitutional remedies. That means every action or legislation passed by the parliament or the state legislature, which in directly contravention to fundamental rights mentioned in part 3 of constitution citizens have the right to approach to Supreme Court by using right to constitutional remedies mentioned in Article 32 and the state high court by Article 226 to get the rights restored by using judicial review by the courts. As you people might be knowing that whenever there is a breakdown or there is a strike by the executive on citizens' rights, citizens can approach the court by using Article 32 directly to the Supreme Court, by using Article 226 to the respective jurisdictional high courts. So whenever this kind of a thing happens, this is the right which helps you to restore your fundamental right. Then the most recent case was striking down of NJAC by the court by using the right to constitutional remedies by the Supreme Court. As you people might be aware that National Judicial Appointment Commission was struck down by the Supreme Court by saying it is taking away the judicial review, because judicial review is one of the basic structures of Indian Constitution after Keshavananda Bharati judgment 1973. Then if right to constitutional remedy or Article 32 is not there, the citizens will be helpless against a powerful executive. Citizens will be very, very helpless. Government can change the rule and take away the rights of the citizens. And because of Article 32 is there, citizens have the right to approach to Supreme Court to restore their own rights. Rightly described by Dr. Ambedkar as fundamental of all fundamental rights. Judicial review, which I have already said, is one of the basic structures of Indian Constitution after Keshavananda Bharati judgment 1973. Now, moving to the next question. Now, coming to the next question. Next question is, they examine the relevance of the fundamental duties of Indian citizen as contained in part 4A of the Indian Constitution. In this question, you have to know what is the demand of the question. The question says the relevance of the fundamental duties. It means that you not only have to know what is the fundamental duty, but you have to relate it to the current day scenario, how it is relevant in today's perspective. So, the first of our fundamental duties is to abide by the constitution and respect its ideals, institution, national flag and national anthem. As you might be aware, there are certain instances which are happening in today's time that knowingly and unknowingly some citizens are not respecting our constitution, its idols and national flag as well as national anthem. So in today's perspective, it is very much relevant. So now coming to the second one, to cherish and follow the noble ideals which inspired the national struggle for freedom. It is also very much essential duty, because if we will not cherish how we have got our freedom, then we will disregard in later parts, later times. So it is very much relevant in today's time. Then to uphold and protect the sovereignty, unity, integrity of India, it is very, very essential. Because see, in certain parts of India, people are taking arms, Maoist insurgency. Then some people are helping our enemy nations. In that perspective, unity, integrity, and some people are raising communal tensions between communities, which are also very bad for our nation. So it is the duty to protect and sovereignty, unity, integrity of India. Then to defend the country and render national service when called upon to do so. The fourth one says, to defend the country and when called upon to do so. As you might be aware that we are surrounded by bad evil relationship with Pakistan as well as China. So there are two enemies where we were engaged in the war in the past. So if we really want to survive in our country, we need to be always ready to render service or defend the nation when called upon to do so. If we will survive only, then we will enjoy all the democratic fruits. Then to promote harmony and spirit of common brotherhood and renounce practice derogatory to the women. It is very, very essential, because there are certain people which are disregarding certain communities, certain caste, creed, religion, as well as certain people. There are very heinous crimes are happening against women, which are totally not acceptable in a civilized society. So this particular fundamental duty is very, very relevant. Then to value and preserve the rich heritage of our composite culture. See, India is a nation where so many different cultures and so many different communities live together. So in that perspective, we have to preserve our composite culture. Starting from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, we are one. So we have to preserve it. Then to protect and improve the natural environment, including the forests, lakes, rivers, wildlife, and to have compassion for the living creatures. It is very, very essential, because in the, you might be aware, because of global warming, there are so many natural disasters which are happening in today's time. So if we really want a good environment, we have to do our constitutional duty, which is mentioned in our part 4a, that is, we have to respect our environment, forests, lakes, as well as compassion towards all the living creatures. Because if all living creatures will extinct, even human as a race will also extinct. Then to develop scientific temper, humanism, and the spirit of inquiry and reform. It is also very important, because if there will not be a spirit of inquiry, there will not be any sort of humanism, scientific temper, we will not progress in our life. So this is also very, very relevant in today's context, where we are living in a scientific age. Then to safeguard public property and to abjure violence. It is very, very essential in today's time. Some people, when they feel let down by the government, they burn the public property and indulge themselves in various kind of antisocial work, which is not acceptable in a civilized society. we as a responsible citizen, we have to, there is a democratic way where we have to project our grievances by not by being violent and spoiling the public property. Then, to strive towards excellence in all spheres of individual as well as collective activity, so that the nation constantly rises higher level and endeavor and achievement. It is also very very important when we as an individual progress, our nation progress with us. If I am a sports person, if I will bring good by becoming the best runner, by bring a Olympic medal or participate in any world event and bring laurels, our nation's pride improves in the international stage. So it is also our duty, in our constitutional duty, we have to progress. Who is the parent and a guardian to provide opportunities for education to the child, as the case may be, what between the age of 6 and 14 years? This particular fundamental duty, which is being added to our constitution by 86th Constitutional Amendment Act 2002. See, what happens if we will not give education to the our children, then we are keeping them in dark. We are keeping the nation's future in dark. So that is the reason why it is very very essential, being a parent, being a guardian, we have to give them education starting from the age of 6 to 14. So all of this fundamental duties are very much relevant in today's context and even in future. So we can conclude by saying that all these fundamental duties mentioned in part 4A of Indian Constitution are very much futuristic. It is relevant. It was relevant yesterday, it is relevant today, and it will be relevant in future also.